They mentioned a couple of them, but the one that sort of jumps out is this idea that the person who they sort of held up as possibly responsible for this crime, Joan Harmon, took the Fifth and didn't have to testify in the trial. But their issue is that the judge didn't make her come in and actually elocute to the Fifth Amendment, taking the Fifth Amendment. I want to get your thoughts on that as a possible appealable issue.
I think that is an appealable issue. And, you know, when I was watching this trial, I couldn't wait to hear, you know, what does this woman have to say? And the fact that she did not physically come into the courtroom and actually plead the Fifth, I believe that is an appealable issue, because what if she changed her mind at the last minute? Who knows?
You know what's interesting? If she took the stand, I mean, one of the things that you have to understand in terms of appeals, and correct me if I'm wrong, is that the judge has to decide that it would have changed the outcome or had some effect on the outcome of the trial. Do you think that that would have been the case?
Oh, I think it definitely would have been the case, because she is the person that, you know, Mr. Martin's defense team was trying to pin this on. She's the one that had reason, you know, as part of their defense strategy, to do something like this, and she's the reasonable doubt. So I think that if the jury would have had a chance to just look at her demeanor, even if it was just to plead the Fifth, to take a look at this person, all we have is the photo that's being shown. We've never heard from this person. I think it would be something that could go on appeal and possibly be overturned. It's possible.
Yeah, the only time we saw her, Susan, is on video, because she had one of the victim's phones and she took it into a phone store. So that tells you everything you need to know. All right, Susan, stand by. I'm being told we have to take a break right now, and we have a lot more ahead for you.